In the early 1970s, on a small stage tucked into the conservative Indian streets of Madras, electric guitars crunch out the chords to hits from the US and UK. Creedence Clearwater Revival, Clapton, Cream. The band is recognized citywide, not for its music, but for the same reason chaperones wait to take its guitarist straight home after the set. Because Indra Nooyi was a young woman, and she wasn't letting India stop her.
I used to climb trees, I used to scrape my knees, I played in a rock band, I played women's cricket. I have no idea how my parents allowed me to do it, but I was the son they never had until they had the son. So I was a rebel in every which way. So in South Indian Brahmin families, you do three things. You respect your elders, you study hard and get good grades, and then you get married at age 18 if you're a girl. Those are the three things you did. The studying hard was fine, respecting elders was fine. Getting married at 18 was just not fine.
Nooyi went to college instead, majoring in chemistry, physics, and math before becoming interested in business management. Here she beat the odds, getting accepted to a university with only 10 seats for women because there were only 10 women's dorm rooms.
For a woman to get into business school was like getting a Nobel Prize.
After graduation, Nooyi joined Johnson & Johnson in India as the product manager in charge of launching a new line of feminine products. It was an impossible position. Indian laws banned any form of advertisement for women's products. Stores couldn't even put them on the shelves. After a year, Nooyi needed a change of pace.
You know, in the late 70s, the U.S. was everybody's hope and dream to come to.
Intrigued by an article about the Yale University School of Management, Nooyi applied, and to her surprise, was accepted with a partial scholarship. But she had virtually no money, and at the time, India permitted its citizens to take only $500 beyond its borders, total, per person, for a lifetime.
I had to buy winter clothes and used up $200 or $300 of it right there.
She supported herself in the U.S. on minimum wage jobs, and with no suit, wore her sari to interviews with high-powered firms. In 1994, Nooyi was so highly sought after that Jack Welch from General Electric went up against Pepsi-Co in a bid for her. When Welch told Pepsi-Co CEO Wayne Calloway that Nooyi had accepted GE's offer, Nooyi got a humbling phone call from Calloway asking her to reconsider.
The humility with which he talked to me touched me. And at that moment, I said, Wayne, I'm joining Pepsi-Co.
Nooyi was an instant success. Sensing a consumer shift toward healthy products, Nooyi helped orchestrate a series of headline-grabbing mergers that helped PepsiCo shift its business model away from unhealthy food choices. The strategy was so successful, the board named her CEO in 2006. It was the right choice. Just 2 years later, in 2008, she saw the company safely through the financial crisis. That same year, Forbes named her the third most powerful woman in the world. With Nooyi in charge, PepsiCo expanded globally into a provider of healthy food options. Under her, the reimagined company's sales grew by 80%, almost tripling its annual net profit from $2.7 billion to $6.5 billion.
I mean, if I told you that it was smooth sailing all the way, I'd be lying. Lots of challenges, people questioning what my background was, why should I even be in PepsiCo in such a senior position, why I was so outspoken and what's with this woman? You know, a lot of stuff like that, but I didn't care about that. I was getting paid to do a job, and I was going to do the job. And I was going to do it better than anybody else. That's the end of it.
After more than two decades of unrivaled success, Nooyi stepped down as CEO in 2018. The PepsiCo she leaves behind flickers with the flame of the old Madras rock guitarist. Today, more women occupied senior positions than ever before. On-site daycare centers bring employees closer to their families. And most important to Nooyi, with new community outreach and environmental programs, PepsiCo has purpose.